What if the Earth Federation lost the One Year War? Alternate scenario or theory today, we're gonna say that the Battle of Abao Ku is where this theory takes place. During this battle, somehow Cassilia survives the assassination attempt by Shara Aznable, and because of this, she's able to live another day and still run Zeon, because we're gonna assume that her brother still dies and everybody else is dead, but she's the only one that survives and keeps the Zeon running still. So she escapes, and the war's still going on because they still got leadership in Zeon. So this is where we're gonna say the war changed.
Is that Char?
Mission failed. We'll get him next time.
Alright, outcome number one, Zeon domination. With the Earth Federation defeated, the Principality of Zeon would emerge as the dominant force in space and on Earth. Zeon would dominate Earth and space, and they would spread their influence on all the colonies and probably most likely oppress the people of Earth. Outcome number two, continued conflict. The defeat of the Earth Federation would not mean an end to the war. However, resistant movements and factions loyal to the Federation will likely continue to fight against Zeon's rule. Guerrilla warfare and insurgency will become the norm, leading to prolonged conflict. There might be some remaining factions of Earth Federation soldiers that are still fighting against Zeon, but they would be, pointless. I mean, Zeon at that point would be too much for him. It's pretty much pointless. Outcome number three, colonies independence. The loss of the Earth Federation would also embolden the various colonies to seek independence from Zeon's control. Many of the space colonies might declare themselves as independent nations, leading to fragmented governance and increased tensions. These tensions would be between the space colonies and Zeon, and I bet Zeon would be happy about the space colonies being independent. So yeah, that'll be another war potentially. So yeah, Zeon won't like the independence of the space colonies. Outcome number four, shift in power dynamics. The defeat of the Earth Federation would result in a significant shift in the balance of power. Zeon would become the dominant military and political force, while the remaining Earth Federation remnants and colonies would struggle to regain their footing. So this shift in power would be, I would say, near the end of the war, because this is if Zeon would have won the war. So it's the end of the war. Zeon, they somehow change the tide of war, they shift the power dynamics, and they would be, the number one military in Earth and space. Well, space and Earth. And this shift in power would just be surprising. Outcome number five, the human cost. The One Year War was already a devastating conflict, but if the Earth Federation had lost, the human cost would have likely been even higher, to be honest. Zeon's oppressive rule and continued conflict would lead to increased casualties, destruction, and suffering for both Earth and the colonies. Let's not forget the colony drop that happened, or the gassing of a colony. I mean, Zeon, they don't care about the human lives. So, and then they mentioned the hatred beam. Yeah. So, yeah.
Life could be a dream. If I could take you up in paradise up above. If you would tell me I'm the only one that you love. Life could be a dream. Sweetheart, hello, hello.
Six, technology and mobile suits. Zeon's victory would grant them access to the advanced mobile suit technology, including the powerful Gundam units. And I wouldn't want to think about Zeon with a Gundam. No. Maybe Zeta Gundam, but that's different. Anyways. This would give Zeon a significant military advantage, make it even more challenging for any resistant movements or factions which they're challenged to rule. I mean, Zeon with the vast resources and the mobile suits that the Earth Federation was developing, like Gundam and all the other secret projects, it would really increase Zeon's military strength with the technology and vast amount of mobile suits they can produce and add to their arsenal. So it's important to note these are all speculative outcomes, as the story and universe of Mobile Suit Gundam could take various directions depending on many other variables. Now, with all that said, I hope you guys enjoyed my theory on what if Earth Federation lost the One Year War. Until next time, this has been Gundam Theory, and thank you for watching.